It was a trail that had gone cold, but exploded into life with a reporter right in the middle of it. The shootout between Christopher Dorner and officers chasing him caught on tape. One of those officers was killed. Dorner took refuge in a cabin. It appears he'd spent days in hiding in this mountain community. As police swarmed around the cabin, news helicopters were ordered away and SWAT teams moved in. And then smoke began to rise from the cabin. Within minutes, flames, as the biggest manhunt this area has ever seen, reached its conclusion. No confirmation from police, but officers say no one had left that cabin.
You know, there's still witnesses out there. You know, the over a thousand clues that we have, many of those are related to the investigation and to the murder, and multiple murders. So those witnesses still are key pieces that need to be resolved in terms of the investigation and documented. We don't just stop a murder case simply because we think that the suspect in that case is no longer with us.
Dorner had vowed revenge on the LAPD for firing him from the force in 2009. He's suspected of killing four people. 50 officers and their families have been under armed guard during his reign of terror.
That appears to have come to an end up here in California's ski country. It will take days to sift through the wreckage of that burnt out cabin. But what appears to have happened is that Dorner was forced into his last desperate move when the cleaning ladies arrived at the house where he'd been staying. His former colleagues do appear to have got their man. It ended with more death, and many of the questions may remain unanswered forever. Greg Milam, Sky News, in the San Bernardino Mountains.
Well, we'll go live to the scene in a moment. First, let's remind you, though, of how the story of this manhunt originally unfolded. This all goes back to 2009, when Dorner was sacked from the Los Angeles Police Department. He claims he was the subject of racism and fired for doing the right thing. Dorner posted a manifesto on Facebook threatening LAPD officials, which prompted a widespread protection order for those named and their families. The killing began last Sunday on February 3rd when Monica Kwan and her fiancé were found shot in the town of Irvine. Her father had represented Dorner at his disciplinary hearings. He went on the run last Wednesday after police named him as the main suspect for the two murders. On the same day, he unsuccessfully tried to steal a boat in San Diego to flee to Mexico. And he opened fire on two police cars in Riverside County, killing one officer. On Thursday, he shot dead another police officer in Riverside who was waiting at a red light in a patrol car. Shortly afterwards, officers in Torrance, California, opened fire on a truck that they mistook for Dorner's. A mother and daughter delivering newspapers were injured. Later that day, a burnt-out vehicle confirmed as Dorner's Nissan Titan was discovered in the woods near Big Bear Lake. LA's biggest ever manhunt was by now well underway. Yesterday, police tracked Dorner down in the San Bernardino Mountains and engaged in a firefight. One officer died, another was injured, and the cabin went up in flames.